Welcome. I'm Corlaine Gardner with the Interpreter Program, managed by the Grassland Naturalists and based in beautiful Police Point Park. But today, I'm in another beautiful park, Kinkooly. And with me today is Craig Renny, the Horticultural Services Technician, better known as the Tree Guy with Parks and Recreation. Welcome, Craig.
Hello. Thanks for coming down to our neck of the woods.
Well, it's a beautiful neck of the woods. And in particular, we wanted to talk about one of your projects, the wildlife trees. Do you want to give us a background on this?
Yeah, sure. It's something that's been around for a long time. And when I came to the City of Medicine Hat a couple years ago now, I realized that it might have been something that we were lacking. And wildlife trees are absolutely crucial to the critters of our environment, whether it be birds, insects, anything. They need those trees, whether they're dead or not, for housing and food. So we decided to kind of implement a minor program where we're going to take some trees that might not be in the greatest health, coming to the end of their lifeline, and we're going to designate them as wildlife trees. And what we'll do in those cases is alleviate any potential hazards with branches over roads or benches and stuff like that. And then we'll attach a sign to them, a wildlife tree sign, that kind of explains a little bit why they're there. And then we'll retain these trees and monitor them, of course, in case other hazards appear. And then they can be utilized by the animals and the insects.
Well, that's a really good point, because trees go through a life cycle like everything else, and they're valuable to wildlife at all stages, and even when they fall and become a log, they're still valuable habitat, a place to live for a lot of animals. So will we see these designated trees in all the parks, or just in some of them? Or
well, it has to be a fair candidate. We don't want to have any serious hazard concerns with it. And as they appear, I mean, we ask that even if the public sees a tree that might be declining in health, that could be a potential candidate, feel free to give us a call, and I can come out and have a look, and maybe it is a candidate. And I mean, we only have a couple right now, but I expect that's going to grow with an aging urban forest. We're going to find trees that we can utilize for this and just help the environment as a whole.
Okay, so we've got one across the creek from us right now.
We do. It's my very first one, actually, across the creek.
The first wildlife tree designated in Kinkooly here.
Correct.
And we'll see some throughout the city, and
absolutely,
People can keep an eye out for them.
Definitely, yep.
Thanks very much, Craig. Thanks for joining us. If you want to learn more about wildlife trees, or if you have any questions about the whole idea and the program, give us a call on the Nature Line, 403-529-6225. And get out and enjoy Kinkooly, the wildlife trees, Police Point, and our whole great park system. We'll see you soon.